Something which nobody expected to happen, and the whole world has gone upside down. The whole thinking has to change. Initially, when COVID started off, people thought it's like possibly like the SARS virus or the Nipah or any of these other viruses which were around the air, in the air in the last 10 to 15 years. But then slowly it became quite evident that this virus is very contagious, and it spreads very fast, and the mortality rates were also increasing. So what governments across the world did was they just shut down the public spaces. Every activity was brought down to a standstill. That was very easy to do, to declare a standstill. And you know the challenges that were there, especially in our own country, how people found it difficult to move back to their respective towns and villages. People were stranded on the roads and people kept moving. But then you can't keep an economy shut down forever. So the government has then decided that we will slowly restart the economy. So when you restart, what will you do? What we did in Tata Consulting Engineers, TCE, is something very unique. TCE is engaged in the engineering, design, as well as project management services across a wide spectrum, both in the CapEx as well as in the OpEx sides of the business. And we had more than 100 sites, construction sites, which were working, and all our sites had to be shut down. So how do we go about restarting it? You just can't bring the people back to the site and start work again. So we put together a standard operating procedure or a guidance document, which is quite pictorial also. And post-lockdown, call it as a restart document, and we put it up on our website and made it available for anybody and everybody, whoever wanted to have a look at it and whoever wanted to follow it. And it proved, and it was up and running in early May itself, so that many organizations, as they got together to restart work, they could access it. And we ourselves, as I told you, we had more than 100 sites, so we became useful for us also as a document, as a guidance to what we have to do. So we set it up, we got all our contractors also informed about it. This whole procedure was distributed. We communicated, we had internal meetings within the organization, then we had small meetings held with our contractors in the different places. All our project managers decided that here's the list of things that we actually have to do. So our objective was that we keep the virus out of the workplace. A workplace technically supposed to be an enclosed place with a barricade all around so that prevent anybody or anything to come in and go out. But this is a virus where a barricade is not going to help in keeping it out. So we need to take other measures. The objective was keep the virus out so that people can be brought back to work and we can carry out work safely. So procedures were very clear what has to be done for prior to the startup. What are the medical tests that people have to go? We also said the government has specified that the Arogya setup has to be installed on your phones. Then at the point of entry at the gate to have hand washing facilities, temperature monitoring facilities, and in case that we find that somebody is infected, there has to be a quarantine facility available, tie up with the local government authorities, tell them that we will be starting work, and check whether they have the sufficient facilities to handle any patients who have, for example, to be oxygenated or who get serious. And then the other side is being construction labor, most of them get housed on the near the construction site itself. So we have a huge labor camp, and in some labor camps where you have 2,000 people who have to be housed. So the labor camp had to be made ready. Usually you have 10 to 15 people staying in a room. Now those numbers had to be slashed down. We allowed not more than 5 to 7 people to stay in a room. So it was very clearly told them this is what we will be doing. And then we needed to have isolation rooms, rooms where in case somebody gets affected, they had to be taken and put into those quarantine rooms. Set up a medical facility also available. A team of paramedical team was also available so that every day the temperature gets monitored. The hygienic conditions of the labor camps had to be monitored. Many of the places, the workers themselves cook their food. So they all congregate together. So there also physical distancing norms had to be established. And we had to draw circles to show exactly what should be the distance that had to be maintained. In addition, have their food storage also kept out neatly laid out so that you don't have crowding at any point of time. Then have a record of every single person being tested checks for their temperatures every day. And in case somebody is found to be positive, have a system where we can trace back to his own village also where he has come from. So that we would try to support the government also in this area to ensure that people from the village that they have come in have been tracked. So, and one of the critical things that we did is we said only 30% of the workforce will be allowed to come back to site. Now that's taking care of the workmen. Then the offices also have to be taken care of, where you have the staff, the engineers and other staff who are working in the project. So there also sanitization programs are done. Staff were given the necessary personal protective equipment like masks and gloves where they have to use. They were trained actually how to wash their hands and how to maintain distance. All these other physical activities to ensure that there can be a kind of zero human contact with each other. So we create an environment where people will be forced to follow the no touch, no contact economy into which the whole world has moved in. And as you rightly said, I always look at it as saying that you are working with one of your hands tied. Why is your hand tied? Because you have to use that part of your body to actually take care that COVID virus is kept out of the system, you know, figuratively. So that is the biggest challenge that we were having. Because then you have issues of productivity coming down. How do you manage that? Yeah, after all, an organization is a business. They are investing money. There has to be a return on the investment. So you cannot just run the site on a loss. Then the biggest other challenge that we found was the work was stopped all of a sudden. All equipment, etc. was just abandoned in whatever condition it was. So before restarting the work on the equipment, you needed to physically check the safety parameters attached to that equipment. May and June and July, all these months, we've been hearing about major accidents happening in process plants. One of them was the LG plant, which explosion occurred in Vishakhapatnam. And a lot of people were affected. There were fatalities. Some have inhaled the gas, and they would have long-term effects. So there was no restart safety review of that plant, and they just restarted. That was one of the bigger cases. Then you have a situation where even a power plant exploded in Telangana. There are also about 25-30 fatalities were there. Then other smaller plants around the place, other smaller power plants. So people just abandoned the place. They came back without looking into the safety requirements in running the plant or restarting the plant. Everybody was focused on how to keep COVID out. On that, you had a great degree of success. But the actual physical safety of the plant to restart was never considered as something very serious. And then you also even had a crane which collapsed and killed several people in Vishakhapatnam in shipyard. So you see, there was a lot of tragedies happening, a lot of, I would say, disastrous events happening, and people's lives were being taken. So all these are well in mind, and that's how DC also decided that we have to be cautiously optimistic on how we carry on with our work. And so from the beginning, we ensured that we will ensure that the guidance will be adhered to. We had a very strict monitoring program in place. And once the work had started, I personally was involved in not physically inspecting. We have reached a good stage of digitization. So Microsoft Teams is a very common tool which everybody uses. So I had this team assembled on the site, and then a couple of them are sent out to the site with their telephones, which had smartphones with cameras switched on. And we used to take a walk around the entire site to see that both the COVID norms as well as safety, which is mandatory, was being complied with. And we took walks through the labor camps, the entrances, the staff, the workmen, especially the guards were questioned on how you would allow a person onto the site. So that we were fully sure that whatever possible which is within our control as an organization, we would implement it. And we were quite successful, but unfortunately, there were cases of people getting affected. That's something which nobody can prevent. It can still come about. But we had the self-belief and the self-assurance that we have done everything possible to keep the virus out of our construction sites. And we've been, now we have almost got back to our full strength levels.